The construction sector accord has been presented as a solution for a sector in crisis or even on the verge of collapse. But was it really required, or is it an example of an unnecessary state intervention on the part of politicians? Joining us with his view is National Leader Simon Bridges.
Hey, Jake.
What do you think?
I think it's another working group on top of 300 they've already had, and I think that's to mask a lack of substantive action. You know, they promised the world going to the election and they're not delivering that.
In saying that, haven't we had an issue with some of these contracts for state-run projects?
Yeah, but is another talk fest the answer? I mean, I think if you boil it all back and you think about housing, we know what to do. Actually, I think even the government sort of does, although they may not like the answers, and that's RMA and planning reform to free up land. It's building supplies and dealing with that, and it's getting a lot more workers
into it. But
these
are big-ticket projects, though. I mean, what would you do, you know, for the likes of Fletcher's who have been having a really difficult time lately?
Well, I think ultimately you stand back and you say they signed contracts. Though they may have been unwise
to have done that. Contracts are a race to the bottom. That's the problem.
Yeah,
and there may be a bit of
point about that, but it's not sort of some radical answer, and I don't think actually a talk fest over what is it the next 18 months past the election is necessarily going to solve anything. As I say, I think it just masks deeper lying issues. What do Kiwis care about? They want more houses built, and that's RMA and planning reform. That's dealing with the buildings and building supplies issues, and that's getting more people into trades, which I mean, this government's actually, by getting rid of ITOs, doing the opposite.
You are expecting a capital gains tax announcement or something to be signed off by Cabinet sometime this week?
My clear understanding is that it will go to Cabinet today. They'll make decisions. They'll announce it on Thursday on the eve of Easter. It's pretty cynical, I've got to say. And then what it will be, in a sense, the minority report of the tax working group. So rentals and properties. And all I'd sort of say about that is, look, National, I think, has forced this. It's not all of the Cullen stuff by being relentless about this in a sense, but let's not be fooled. Just because you're not getting kicked in the leg doesn't mean being punched in the arm is any good, and this will still be a real punch in the arm.
First of all, how do you know it's going to be done today, this week?
Number of sources, credible. Okay. I mean, I don't know as much as I'm certain that I'm sitting here next to you, but I understand it and I think I'm right.
Okay, what are you expecting in terms of numbers? Are you expecting a drop in that marginal rate for the CGT?
I think what it will be, and I don't know exactly, but I think what it'll be is broadly, if you look at the minority report, they say rest is crap, don't like it. It's not quite the word they use, but that's what they say. What we think has some justification is everything on rentals. And if you think about it, we've already got a bright line test, which is a sense clarifying the rules around rampant speculation. This, though, will be much more than that. It'll effectively be saying for the long-term to mum and dad and resters with the one rental, we will, when you sell it on your retirement, take a third of that.
Let's talk about foreign political influence.
Yep.
The SIS is concerned about it in New Zealand. Would you support a ban on foreign donations?
Yes, I would. I think, let's just take a step back. Remember now, and it's got its complications, but remember now, for the most part, it's entirely illegal, right? But there are some things I think you can clear up and make it completely illegal. I think the Justice Select Committee, which is going through this, got National, Labor, etc. members on it, that's the right place to deal with it. And the only sort of point I would make at a deeper level, if you like, is this. Immigrants who come to New Zealand, residents, citizens, we want them to be involved in politics, actually. So this is not what this is about. I think it has to be about genuine foreign influence, if you like, foreign powers, foreign interests influencing New Zealand's political process. That's obviously just wrong.
All right. Thanks for your time this morning.
Cheers.
We appreciate it. National Leader Simon Bridges. If you want to get in touch, you can find us on Facebook by searching Breakfast on One, or you can flick us an email, breakfast@tvnz.co.nz.